Wow, you've really been impressing me with your work on the rainbow bird story this week. It's a fantastic story and I'm really glad that you've enjoyed listening to it and actually retelling it yourself orally. We've also had a really good practice of speech punctuation because obviously speech between Crocodile Man and Rainbow Bird is really important in the story. So as many of you have already actually had a go at this, but what I'm going to ask you to do today, and you can certainly still carry on working on this tomorrow, is to retell the story and to rewrite the story kind of in your own words. And because you've remembered so much of it already, then that will hopefully be something that you can do really confidently. Now, if you've already had a go at doing that, which I know quite a lot of you already have, that's absolutely fine, because we're going to talk about the features of making a great myth story. And so you'll be able to go back to what you've already done and maybe then up level and slightly change some of your redraft some of the sections as well. So you'll be able to maybe use what we've learned about speech punctuation to check all of that as well. But either way, whether you've done it already or not, you will still end up with your version of the rainbow story written down, which will be super fantastic. So you will need your pencil and your paper, and if you have worked on already writing the rainbow bird story, then you will need that as well. Okay then, let's get started. So here's our checklist of the features of the myth which we've used for Rainbow Bird. And these are the things that we're going to be making sure that we do a really good job of when we write the story. Obviously, we've got the story structure, which we know really well. We've remembered it. And we know that it explains a natural phenomena, which is fire. So we're going to be looking at the traditional opening of the story and maybe slightly changing it. Instead of using the one that was used exactly in the story that we read, we might maybe amend it, change it, and use a slightly different but still traditional story opener. We're going to be looking at the adjectives and powerful verbs used to describe the characters Crocodile Man and Rainbow Bird, and again seeing if we could perhaps keep some of the ones that we like, rough, tough, crocodile, but maybe we could change those adverbs and verbs in our version. And then we've got obviously our speech, which you practiced yesterday, which you'll be able to bring into this. And we're definitely going to sort of hang on to those connective signposts, but we could perhaps start each paragraph with a slightly different connective. So let's have a look at a few of those key things together. And then I would like you to rewrite the story yourself. And remember, can you work on this today and tomorrow? I'm not going to put another video up tomorrow, so because I know you've got plenty to be doing with your creative arts work as well. So let's get started. So when you're writing the Rainbow Bird story, we need to start with a traditional opener. And in the book, it says, long ago in the time of dreams, when the world was being born, there lived a rough, tough crocodile man. He was huge and mean and scary. See what I mean? We've learned it really well, haven't we? But we could change that. And here are just a few ideas, or you could even come up with your own ideas for a traditional opener to change it if you like. Many, many years ago, at the beginning of time, in a land that came to be known as Australia, there lived So you can change it. Or even way, way back in dream time, when spirit animals were roaming the earth. And we've got all that long ago and far away, lived. So you can choose your own traditional story opening. So the opening that I'm going to use, changed it slightly again. I'm going to write, I have written, many, many years ago, at the dawn of creation, when spirits and animals roamed the earth, there lived. So if you're starting from scratch, choose which sentence, which story opening you're going to use, and write it down. Have a good think what exactly what you want it to be. It makes it sound such a special story, doesn't it? Long ago in dream time, when the world was being born, da da da. If you've already had a go at writing it earlier this week, maybe you could go back at this point and think, which one would I actually like to use? And then we'll move on. So another key thing that we can change about the story and we can add to is our description of the characters using adjectives. And of course, we'll remember that some of the adjectives which were pretty good, which we really liked, rough, tough, because it rhymed. And we like to find out that actually this crocodile was huge and mean and scary. So I think what we should do is just make a note of some adjectives to describe the different characters, and then we can sort of bring them in to our writing as we go. So if I start with the crocodile man, and you just pause the video and just write down crocodile man, and let's add, see if we can add some adjectives to describe him. Okay. What I mean, he was mean, wasn't he? So I'm thinking other words that would be great for that would be selfish. He was greedy. He did not want to share. That's another good word. Did not want to share his fire, did he? So he was nasty, unkind. He was really grumpy, and if I think of some other high level kind of words, vocabulary for this, he could be heartless. He was pretty heartless. He didn't think about anybody else, did he? Some of them get really strong. I mean, evil, I'm not sure he's evil. It could be, but it could be a bit too strong. Stony hearted. So we can go for it really with our adjectives to describe the crocodile man. As for the rainbow bird, well, I'm just going to ask you to pause the video actually and just catch up and write down a few of the adjectives that you think describe crocodile man. Okay, so as for the rainbow bird, she's kind of the opposite, isn't she? She is kind, she is generous. She is compassionate, which is a good word that means that she thinks of others. She's really worried for the people because they haven't got food. They can't cook their food. They have to eat it raw. So she's kind, generous, compassionate, generous hearted, open hearted. She's beautiful as well. And that's something about her. She's feathery. She's got beautiful feathers. She certainly has by the end. I suppose at the beginning her feathers are not that beautiful, they're just quite dull and ordinary, aren't they? So you could make a note mention of that. But other words for beautiful, once she becomes the rainbow bird, are spectacular. Oops, I know somebody the other day used the word magnificent, which I thought was great. Beautiful, magnificent, dazzling. Dazzling rainbow feathers, wondrous. So there's lots of ways that we can add to the adjectives that we're using to describe the characters. And again, it could be useful to have some verbs that we think that things, the kind of things that the crocodile man and the rainbow bird do. So I think that we can remember things like the crocodile man growled, snapped. When he's speaking, maybe he lashed out with his tail, lashed out, he laughed. I can imagine him, he glowered, how he looked through his mean staring eyes. That was a good phrase, I might try and remember that. He glared. Maybe he's even making fun of people. Maybe he mocked Rainbow Bird or made fun of her. He's really nasty and mean. Okay, and again we could have some adverbs in there such as selfishly or grumpily or meanly. So just have just pause there and add a few words to your word bank or meanly, selfishly, grumpily, all of the kind of things. Okay, and then for Rainbow Bird, the kind of things that she does, well, she's a bird and she flies. So I love the way it's in the text, it said she flashed down and she snatched the fire sticks. I love that. And there's other things, obviously, verbs for synonyms for flew, like fluttered, swooped. Maybe when she's enjoying being up in the air and not down in the ground, she could zoom or soar, soared. And we're quite good at thinking of these. She danced in the sky would be a great one, with her dazzling rainbow feathers trailing behind. So we've got lots of ideas there of adjectives and powerful verbs to help us with our writing. And then, of course, we're going to include the speech in our story so we can actually change the things that the characters say, and we can practice using our speech punctuation again. So I'm just going to get you started and then you can get cracking with that. Those are the main things to try and think about when we're retelling the story. OK, so we're going to start off together and then you can carry on trying to add use those great adjectives and verbs and retelling the story. So we started with our sentence of our traditional story open already, didn't we? I've got many years ago at the dawn of creation, when spirits and animals roamed the earth, there lived. Now I'm just going to look back at my words that I've gathered. There lived a selfish, heartless creature. A selfish, heartless creature. Called Crocodile Man. For Crocodile Man alone had the gift of fire. And oh but he loved to play with fire. Yeah, which we shouldn't do. Oh, but he loved his fire. And I really like that repetitive language that we had the other day, so I might actually use it sometimes. He placed it on his foot. Sometimes he breathed it from his throat. Sometimes he balanced it on his head. But Crocodile Man would never share his fire. Brilliant. So let's think what I've just written. Many years ago at the dawn of creation, when spirits and animals roamed the earth, there lived a selfish, heartless creature called Crocodile Man. For Crocodile Man alone had the gift of fire, and oh, but he loved his fire. Sometimes he placed it on his foot. Sometimes he breathed it from his throat. Sometimes he balanced it on his head. But never would he share his fire. When the other animals begged him for fire, he just laughed. You may not have my fire. And so on. So there we go. I've made a start. Now I've got those connectives that I've just listed on this slide here, so that that reminds me as I'm moving through the story which part's coming next. And the next part, once we've really talked about the Crocodile Man, is to introduce the Rainbow Bird, of course. And that in the story was in a nearby tree, and I really like that. I really like the way one of you, I can remember who it was, actually, instead of that, wrote watching in a nearby tree, which I really like, because that just gives me that extra information that rainbow bird was watching Crocodile Man the whole time. So watching in a nearby tree. Comma. Was a kind, feathery rainbow bird. Full stop. And I'm going to write, like all the other animals, she was often cold. Comma. She had to eat her food raw. And she had no light in the darkness of night time. And that's when my speech is going to come here in here. So let's see what I've written already. Watching in a nearby tree was a kind feathery rainbow bird. Like all the other animals, comma, she was often cold. She had to eat her food raw and she had no light in the darkness of night time. Now, what did we say that rainbow bird might say when she pleaded? So we've got our speech marks here, capital letter. Please share your fire. Comma, speech marks. So we need to remember that comma before the final speech marks. Please share your fire, pleaded rainbow bird. And then I'm going to split that dialogue. So the reporting clause in the middle here. Please share your fire, pleaded rainbow bird. So I'm going to put another comma here and more speech marks, but I don't need a capital letter. And then I'm going to write, please share your fire, pleaded rainbow bird. We need to cook our food. And then our full stop, end of speech marks. And then, because it would be Crocodile Man's turn to speak, what would we do? Start a new line, that's all right. What would he say? So please share your fire. We need to cook our food. And he would say, no, grunted rainbow. No, grunted Crocodile Man, meanly swiping her away with his tail. I'm just going to write that sentence so that I modelled that for you. Last thing I'll do, I think. Okay, so speech marks, no, and this is an exclamation mark because he's been really surprising. No. So I don't need a comma as well. Grunted Crocodile Man. So our synonym for said is grunted this time. It could be croaked, cross crocodile. No, croaked, cross crocodile. And they've got that brilliant alliteration in there, haven't we? No, grunted Crocodile Man. I'm going to use an adverb, selfishly, greedily, greedily guarding. Oh, yeah. Greedily guarding his precious flames or his precious fire sticks. And he swiped her away. With his tail. There we go. Full stop. Oh, no, grunted cross crocodile man. I could even put that in there, couldn't we? No, grunted cross crocodile man. Greedily guarding his precious fire sticks. and he swiped her away with his tail. Amazing. You guys are so good at writing. You are definitely ready for year five. I think you're going to be amazing. So we've got such quality going on, haven't we? And this is a great story for you to practice writing because you know it so well now. So as you go through, as you get to each point, then just think, how can I add it? Just change it just slightly, different verbs, different adjectives, using that speech. And you're doing a really, really great job, everybody. So I'll just read back through this paragraph. And that's the other thing that I would mention, is that make sure you're starting new paragraph for each new section in the story. That's a really key thing in year four, is to get used to a section of the story, say the opening or the build up or the climax, is a new paragraph. So start a new line. Have a look at your writing if you did it the other day. If it was all in one big chunk without any paragraphs, see if you can figure out where those paragraphs should come. And these connectives should probably help you, because as we get to a new one of these connectives, that signals a new paragraph here. So my new paragraph was the one in a nearby tree, but we watched. Watching in a nearby tree was a kind, feathery rainbow bird. Like all the other animals, she was often cold. She had to eat her food raw, and she had no light in the darkness of nighttime. "Please share your fire," pleaded Rainbow Bird. "We need to cook our food." And then, new line. "No," grunted Cross Crocodile Man, greedily guarding his precious fire sticks. And he swiped her away with his tail. And I think then the Rainbow Bird would say, "But what about people? They need to cook their food too." But the Crocodile Man just laughed and curled his huge body around the flames. I think that's really good. And then we would move on to saying about how Rainbow Bird kept watching and waiting. Every day Rainbow Bird watched and waited, waited and watched. Then one afternoon she saw her chance, full stop. Crocodile Man took the longest, widest, sleepiest, most enormous yawn that anyone had ever seen. Love that. And at that, she swooped down. Look at my words that I gathered earlier. She swooped down, or she splashed down. She snatched a fire stick. And there was nothing Crocodile Man could do. Immediately she zoomed from tree to tree, placing a fire in the heart of the tree. And from that day on, people have been able to use trees, to dry trees and wood, to make fire. They can cook their food, keep warm in the cold, and light their way in the dark. And then we're nearly there, aren't we? Then we've got that end conversation between Rainbow Man and Crocodile Bird. But that's about it. So I'm really, really delighted with the work that you've done on Rainbow Bird. And all the best writing it. It's quite a big job. I say some of you have already done it, so you need to sort of go back and improve and up level and redraft. But there won't be another lesson tomorrow, so have a little go. All right then, thanks everybody. So when you've finished your retelling, remember always to read back through your work, just to check that all your sentences make sense, check that we've used punctuation correctly, and also just to say well done to myself for using all of these features of a folk tale, of a myth. Well done. So just to recap, you can work on this today and tomorrow. I know that you're really busy with your creative arts work as well, so that's the main thing, obviously, is to for everybody to get something for the creative arts gallery. So I'd love to see that. And then next week in our literacy activities, we're going to have a little break from Rainbow Bird, and we're going to be starting to prepare some work for our end of year celebration assembly. And that will be in the literacy activities on Seesaw next week. But I really love how you learned this story, Rainbow Bird, and retold it sort of orally like that. So if we get a chance before the end of term, we might look at another fantastic story, which I think you might like to retell. Thanks, Year 4. Looking forward to seeing your work. Bye.